What's up, Soul Squad? What's up, my Soul Squad? Welcome to what? My channel. Alright, guys, you saw that thumbnail, right? So I'm going to show you how I put that red velvet cake together. How we made this amazing, moist, delicious red velvet cake. We doing everything from the homemade cake to the cream cheese frosting. So guys, sit back, enjoy all the videos, enjoy my channel. Remember to tell everybody we over here doing on this channel. Like, share, subscribe. And are you guys ready? Before we even get started, we must do what? Hit that intro! This is everything we're gonna need. You're gonna need some cocoa. I use this stock specialty cocoa right here. You don't have to use this one, but this is the one. Ooh, I can't even get in my head. This is the one that I like using. We need some baking soda. You need some sour cream. You need some sugar. I use cake flour, but if you want to use regular flour, regular all-purpose flour, you can. You're just going to have to sift it to make it really thin. I use vegetable oil, some buttermilk, some distilled vinegar, and I'll show you what that is. Well, that's a combination of the baking soda and the vinegar. It helps enhance the vibrant color of your red velvet cake. I have 1 ounce of, let's see. This is right. This is 1 ounce of red food coloring. We're going to be using this whole thing. I have some good vanilla. When I'm baking, I try to use pure vanilla. This is an organic pure vanilla extract. That's all I had. And I try to use pure vanilla, or I normally bake with Madagascar vanilla. I don't have that right now. And you need your favorite mixer, blender. You're going to need measuring cups and measuring spoons, guys, because we are baking. And I made it clear that when I bake, there's a lot of measuring going on in baking because, you know, baking is like a science. You want to get it down to the letter, okay? So let's get started. And the first thing we get started, and no, I'm not using my KitchenAid. I could, but I don't feel like using KitchenAid. I tapped out to use my good old hand mixer. It works just as fine. Now, to get started, I'm going to take this bowl right here, and we're going to go in with our Swanson cake mix. I'm going to use 2.5 cups. We're going to measure that out. 2.5 cups. Now, this may not be a description, so I'm doing each ingredient as I said, as I put it in. So 2.5 cups of cake flour, or either regular flour. Remember, you're going to have to sift that flour before you get started. Have my bowl right here. I'm going to go in with my 1/2 cup first. And you can see how when I use this, I level it off. Because you want to make sure that it's exactly what you're looking for. So this is 1/2 cup. I'm sitting this to the side because I'll be using this because I use 1/2 cup of sour cream for my cake. So I'm going in with this. I'm got 1 cup of this. This is a measuring cup. I'm using 1 cup. I'm going to see, can I get it down inside the box? I didn't want to take the whole thing out the box. So, and I'm also leveling this off. When people level off their measuring cups, they sometimes use a back of a butter knife just to level it off. I really don't have to do that. I'll use the box that I'm using just to level it off. And dude, so this is like 1 cup. So now we're up to 1.5 cups. In my bowl. I'm gonna get 1 more cup, and that's gonna make 2.5 cups of what? Cake flour. I use this particular cake flour. I can't think of the other one I like too. and the I think it's Pillsbury and the pink and white. So you can use that as well. I prefer cake flour over regular flour when making cakes. This is my go-to thing. Back in the day, I don't think I ever even used. It's another cup. So this is gonna make 2.5 cups of what? 2.5 cups of your flour or your cake flour. Why not use self-rising flour? Because we're gonna be using baking soda and baking powder. And when you use self-rising flour, those agents are already in the flour, so we're not using that. So if you do decide to use a flour, just use an all-purpose flour. So you know how when you make some cakes, you'll do your butter and sugar separate? Me personally, when I used to sell cupcakes and I make red velvet cupcakes, I don't do my, there's no butter in this. This is an oil-based cake. So I do all my dry ingredients will go together. So my next step is I'm going for 2 cups of white sugar. Some people, and everybody put their cakes together differently. I found out this particular way, it works for me, you know. So I'm going in with 2 cups. And again, I'm using my measuring cups. So that's 1 cup. I got some sugar lumps. You don't want them sugar lumps. Let me just take. I don't want no lumps of sugar. You know how sugar get lumps in? I don't want no lumps of sugar. In my, and I just bought this sugar. I don't know why I had lumps in it. Man, that's something I don't know. Why should we get lumps? We get old, we get wet. So, we got that. 2 cups of sugar. So I'm going in with 2 cups of sugar, guys. And for this particular recipe, that's all I have is 2 cups there. Girl got hit the grocery store. I'm going in with my baking powder, and I do 2 teaspoons. 2 teaspoons. This right here will help you level off. This right here, you ever know what this was for in your baking powder? That is to help you level off that baking powder. So you come up like this, and you'll put it like that. That helps you level it all so that you can get. They help you level it all. Boom. There it is. So, another thing that I got to get. I forgot my salt. Let me get this salt and I'll be right back. Okay, guys. So, I don't use a lot of salt in anything. So I'm using a half a teaspoon. A half a teaspoon of salt. None of that. A half a teaspoon. So I'm only using a half a teaspoon. I know you gotta have salt in your baking. So a half a teaspoon of salt, regular old salt. Now we're gonna go in with our cocoa. Remember, this is not a chocolate cake. This is a red velvet cake, but it has chocolate. It gives you that chocolate flavor. So. This, I'm doing 1 tablespoon. Only 1 tablespoon, guys.
Oh, yeah.
What?
Red velvet is chocolate cake.
Red velvet's not a chocolate cake.
More. Red velvet is chocolate cake. Just read. It's going to be proven.
A chocolate cake has more cocoa in it, more of a chocolate stuff in it. A red velvet only gets one. My red velvet only get 1 tablespoon of cocoa. Now, you don't have to use it specially dark. I buy specialty dark, so when I make a double foods cake, I like that rich overall dark flavor, that darkness. So, but with this, I am only going in with 1 tablespoon. That's all I put in here. That 1 tablespoon. 1 tablespoon of cocoa. So guys, we go ahead and take a picture of this. When we done it, we did all our dry ingredients. And let me go over this real quick with the dry ingredients. 2.5 cups of either all-purpose flour or your favorite cake flour. 2 cups of sugar. 2 teaspoons of baking powder. 1/2 teaspoon of salt. And 1 tablespoon of cocoa. Dry ingredients done. Let's move on. You guys, you know what I forgot to do on camera? I like to stir. So you can take a wire whisk or whatever. I'm just taking what's in front of me. And I like to stir all my ingredients up. Just whisk it. You can take a whisk or whatever you have, spatula, and just get everything incorporated. You know, it don't have to do that much. I just like to get that cocoa in there. Now I'm gonna sit this to the side. So let's get ready for our wet ingredients. Get that paper, pen. 3 eggs, room temperature. Let's go. Three large eggs. Room temperature. I got my 3 eggs. Wet ingredients, 3 eggs, room temperature. I got my vegetable oil. One cup of vegetable oil. I'm gonna set this to the side. 1 cup of vegetable oil. Shaking up my buttermilk at room temperature. 1 cup. One cup of buttermilk, guys. And this is all my wet ingredients. I'm gonna show you when we're gonna use the vinegar and the baking soda. We ain't got to that point yet. Okay. Our vanilla. Again, I love the intensity of good vanilla. I don't use 1 teaspoon, but I use 2 teaspoons. So we go on in with 2 teaspoons of vanilla. If you don't have, because I know these days prices are high. I'm not saying you can't use imitation vanilla. It's just that when I bake, I try not to. So, we're going in. What? 1, 2. We got the wet ingredients. 2 teaspoons. Vanilla smells so awesome. 2 teaspoons of vanilla. These are wet ingredients. And the final wet ingredient is the red velvet. Now, I normally do not use this. When I start making cupcakes, start making red velvet cakes, yes, I use this. This is the go-to that everybody uses. You're going to use the whole thing. But as I got more and more to making cupcakes and selling cupcakes, I discovered something called red velvet. It's a red velvet food coloring, just for red velvet cakes. I used to get it off this place called King Arthur. I haven't had it in a long time. So when I do get that, I only use like 2 tablespoons of that. It's like a thickener. It's like a gel. And it's really, really thick. And I normally only use 2 tablespoons when I have that. But when I don't have that, you are going to go in with this full bottle. A red velvet, the whole bottle. That's it. That's all. So let's do this again. We got wet ingredients. Follow me. 3 eggs, room temperature. 1 cup of vegetable oil. If you don't have vegetable oil, you could use a canola oil. 1 cup of vegetable oil. 1 cup of buttermilk. 2 teaspoons of vanilla. And the whole 1 ounce of red food coloring. That's it. That's all. This is our dry ingredients. And what we're about to do right now is that we're about to blend our dry ingredients together. That's it. That's all. This is our wet ingredients. Somebody said, no, not dry, Miss T. This is our wet ingredients. Again, 3 eggs, room temperature, 2 teaspoons of vanilla, the whole 1 ounce of red food coloring, and we're going to do 1 cup of vegetable oil or canola oil and 1 cup of buttermilk. These are your wet ingredients. These are all the ingredients to make a red velvet. You know the power's up, girls. Just like that, that is blended. We're gonna go in with half the dry ingredients. Red velvet cake. Let's get our half a cup of sour cream. So guys, I am about to start with this. This is a half a cup. I'm gonna start putting in my sour cream using a spoon. I want to measure out a half a cup of the one in the refrigerator with the macaroni in. A half a cup of sour cream. And this is a half a cup of sour cream. Take the rest off my spoon. And I'm going in with this half a cup of sour cream. Guys, this is gonna make your red velvet cake so moist. So moist. And then I'm gonna take y'all on the next journey. How we gonna make our red velvet cake so bright and vibrant. When we use the distilled vinegar, it's 1 tablespoon of baking soda, 1 tablespoon of distilled vinegar. We stir it up together, then we pour it. But that is the last and final ingredient to our mix. Now we're adding in this half a cup of sour cream, guys. And we're gonna mix that. And don't forget about the size. I'm gonna give me a spatula. And I am going to scrape my sides down once I finish mixing this all up. Don't want to over whip. It doesn't take long. All right, let me get together our last and final ingredient to this amazing and easy red velvet cake. Okay, guys. Taking my baking soda. I just opened up brand new. And again, we're going to be measuring it off, leveling it off. okay? And I got my little separate container here. So I'm going in with 1 teaspoon of baking soda. And I'm gonna go in, I have my distilled vinegar. And I'm going in with 1 teaspoon of vinegar. If you can hear the sizzle that the vinegar and but I did 1 teaspoon of vinegar, 1 teaspoon of baking soda. And it has to be the distilled vinegar. It can't be your regular apple cinnamon vinegar. And what you're gonna do, you're just gonna pour that. That much doesn't even come out, guys. You're gonna pour, let me stir it up some more. You're gonna pour it into your red velvet cake mix, because what it's gonna do is gonna make that red velvet stand out. It's gonna make it vibrant. And then we're gonna mix. This is our final mix. Not that long. Okay, let me get my spatula, scrape down these sides, and get my pan ready. Clean up all this mess and get the pan ready. All right, guys, so guess what? I don't have no baking spray. So I'm about to go old school. I'm about to take a piece of paper towel, some butter. I put in the microwave so it could get a little bit soft. And we're about to do what? We're about to grease this pan and flour it. Man, I haven't done it this way in such a long, long time. But you know, this is a 9x13. I'm making a square cake, y'all, because my layer cake, like I said, I could bake. I think I told you guys a long time ago, I could bake the heck out of a cake. But honey, when it comes to frosting and decorating and all that good stuff, I am not that girl. I am not. I'll make sure I get all the corners, because we're going to throw some flour up in here. So, yeah. We going old school. This is how moms before us used to do it. But they came out with all that baking stuff and everything. So, yeah. But you want to make sure you get all the corners and everything. But you want that flour to really stick. My oven is on 350. This is not a long cake. About 30 minutes. 30 to 40 minutes in the oven, guys. That's all. Okay. Take some flour. Some people, I kind of prefer it this way too. It's just that other way is so much easier. And you know, when you already baking, you know. So we're gonna hit the bottom, to coat the bottom, to do like this, and do like that. I got some flour to clean up and do like this. You know what? And then I just hit. There you go. A nice flour pan. Let me clean up this flour. We're going to pour our cake. Guys, I got my nicely floured pan right here. And remember, I want to scrape down the sides. So, I want to scrape down the sides of this cake. Yeah, and of this bowl, okay, and we're just gonna pour it right into my pan. You could get a 3-layer cake out of this, but I'm going old school. I'm doing a nice square cut cake. Sure. Is it possible? So I said, hand me the bowl. All right. In the oven. On 350, y'all. We'll be back with you. So, squad. Look at this cake. It's still hot. So nice and soft. Came out so good. We're going to let it cool down so we can make our what? Cream cheese frosting. And I leave the cake in this pan. This pan actually is a cake pan. It comes with a top. So that's why I like making rectangular square cakes in here, because I got to let the cake cool down, frosting it, and cut, and still be in this same container that we baked it in. So yeah, we're going to let this cool down, come back, and they got cream cheese frosting. All right, guys, while the cake is cooling off, I put a piece of paper towel over it to let it cool off. We're going to make our cream cheese frosting. I got one stick of unsalted butter. I'm going to use about 2.5 cups of, we call it powdered sugar. And we're going to use 1 8-ounce pack of cream cheese, guys. Now, my cream cheese, I took out early this morning, because you want your cream cheese to be at a good room temperature, okay? You want your bowl to be dry. So we're just gonna go here, we're gonna blend together our cream cheese and our butter, guys. And let me get something to open up this cream cheese. I'll be right back. All right, guys, we're back. I got this cream cheese open with my hand. Just had a minute to follow the seams. Okay, so 8 ounces a room temperature cream cheese, and use the whole thing. Now, if you didn't have that much cake, you could use like 4 ounces, like half of this. But we got a lot of cake to frost, and you want to make sure that cake is really cool. So my cake is gonna at least 45 minutes to an hour. I'm gonna let this cake sit. Yeah, and the cake took about 45 minutes or 350 until it was no longer jiggly, to the it pulled away from the sides. It pulled away from the sides of the baking dish. So yeah. And then of course you want your butter, non-stick. And I said non-stick. Unsalted butter at room temperature. And you're gonna take these two ingredients and you're gonna blend together. Let me move my powdered sugar out of the way. And you're gonna blend these two ingredients together. That's why they need to be at room temperature. You got easy to be at room temperature. Now, I know y'all tell y'all measuring is key. So let me get my measuring cup. Okay, guys, I got my measuring cup. I cut open the top part of my powdered sugar, stuck the cup in there, got 1 cup. And I'm gonna start off with 2 cups. So I'm just sticking this back into my pot of sugar. Of course, you guys can't see that, but it's going back into my pot of sugar. If I get another good cup, I want to do about 3, but I'm going to start off. Always start off with less with anything that you're doing. So I'm going to start off with 2 cups of powdered sugar. And let's see, you know, what happens. I think that's why I need is 2 cups. I'm not making a lot. And we're going to do 2 teaspoons. Now, this I am going to eyeball because I know what a teaspoon is. But if you don't, guys, 2 teaspoons of vanilla. So, what we're going to go with, just like I said, it may not be in description. So, we're going to go with what? 1 stick of room temperature unsalted butter. 1 pack of room temperature cream cheese. That's an 8 ounce. 2 teaspoons of vanilla. And we're going to start off with 2 cups of powdered sugar. I haven't decided whether or not I want to add a half a cup or a third. But let's see what we're doing with this. How it comes out. If I get the consistency that I want, I'm good. I don't add any liquid to my cream cheese frosting. About like a thick frosting. Going up on the side. And this is about enough frosting I need for my cake. I don't like a lot of frosting. So, hey. It's creamy. And that's why I don't add any type of liquid. Because by the room temperature of the butter, the room temperature of the cream cheese, it gives you exactly what it is that you need. This is thick enough. Look at that. It's thick enough, it's more than enough for our cake. So with this particular cream cheese frosting recipe, oh my goodness. 2 cups of powdered sugar. 1 8-ounce pack of room temperature softened cream cheese. 1 stick of room temperature unsalted butter. 2 teaspoons of vanilla. The perfect amount for this 9 by 13 cake pan. This is all the frosting we need. All right, guys, once the cake cooled down, we good to go. All right, so squad, let's finish this video, okay? I got my, that cream cheese frosting. Man, I got my cream cheese frosting right here. It's just how I want it. Let me just stir it up real quick. My cake is soft and it's cooled down. Took about an hour for it to cool down. And let's just, again, like I said, I like this pan. I like doing the cake in a square because I could cook it in my baking dish and I could store it in my baking dish. That's just why I love this pan. Man, I'm in love with cream cheese frosting. Can't tell me nothing. Juliet said, I'll be up there in the morning before I go to work. She said, please cut me a piece of cake up, her baby. Because she said, what you doing? I said, making a video. I said, you're going to be mad. She said, why? I said, it's your favorite cake. She said, red velvet. I said, yep. She said, I ain't be mad. She said, on my way to work in the morning, I will be at your door. And it'll be waiting. That's why I had just enough frosting, y'all. And it'll be waiting for it. Had just enough. Just enough frosting. Comment below, what's your favorite cake? Comment below, do you even know how to make homemade cake? Do you prefer a homemade over box or box over homemade? I use all my frosting. So this was just enough frosting to do what I needed to do. And y'all, this is my red velvet cake. What the traditional cream cheese frosting. That frosting could make one smack your mama. Okay, guys. I mean, it's just a plain old red velvet cake. You know, I don't use the nuts to sprinkle over it, but guys, come on. It's homemade. From the cake to the tuna to the cream cheese. And that frosting is amazing. Let's go ahead and cut into this, baby. All right, guys, I got ready. Let's go ahead and cut this cake. I'm sorry. I'm not an edge girl. I do not like edges. So let me see. Michael said, I'm crazy. Look at that, though. Look at that. That's red velvet, baby. Tell me she don't know what she doing. Okay. I'm going to try to dig in that center without messing my cake up. Ooh, yes, baby. Yes, boo. Look at that. Moist. Man, y'all can really see how bright red this thing is. Okay. She came out so good. Look at that. I get y'all a close up of this, boo. So decadent. So soft. Red velvet all day. Let me get y'all a close up. Look, y'all. That's what I'm talking about. There she go. Juliet come to get her piece. Y'all like, share, subscribe. Hit that bell to be notified. Comment if you like nuts without nuts. Go check out You Are Not Alone. It's going to be pinned in the comments. SoulfulT Vlogs. New life journey. Look at the moistness of that cake. And the cooking guy, y'all. Yes, until my next video, I see you guys in the video. Yes.